What is so special about qualitative data analysis, and how does it differ from quantitative data analysis? Firstly, as you probably know, qualitative data analysis and qualitative research in general is about qualities. This means that the purpose of gathering data in qualitative research is to gain a really in-depth insight into the nature of specific experiences, phenomena, beliefs, attitudes, and so on and so forth. And you want to gain that insight from a very personal perspective, not from a general perspective of widely held views. So this is a difference, because in quantitative research you really are interested more in generalizing, in discovering widely held beliefs or views, and investigating more universal phenomena. So for example, the effectiveness or applicability of a specific method or intervention, or in terms of beliefs, again, beliefs held by a broad population. So the purposes are completely different. Also, what is different is the role of you as a researcher in qualitative setting and qualitative study setting. So in qualitative research, you are really becoming a part of that research setting. So you should not ignore that, and you should be aware of it, and you should recognize it and be very open about your possible role in that research and also your possible influence on that research situation. So in quantitative research, the researcher is really the person in charge of applying certain analytic tools and running analytic tests. And as long as these tests or tools are applied correctly, you don't really have to worry about the data being incorrect anymore. And the situation is obviously completely different in qualitative research because of what I already said, because of that role of the researcher, of the possible influence of the researcher on the research situation. So for example, you should ask yourself questions like, do the participants really believe it, or do they just say it because they think that I want to hear it? So this is the example of this possible influence that you bring into the research situation. And when doing qualitative data analysis, because you really want to gain insight into that personal and individual view, what you want to focus on is to understand individual perspectives, understand how your individual participants understand the world, how they define different concepts that they talk about. Is their understanding of these concepts the same as your understanding? So when analyzing data, you will really need to jump forwards and backwards within your data transcripts and try to determine this understanding that your individual participants have of specific experiences. Or also you'll have to decide and pay attention to when they decide to share certain stories, for example. So what kind of interviewer's question prompted them to share their very detailed and personal account, and then what kind of questions seem to have influenced their response, or maybe to change their view a little bit. So it's really all about understanding this individual perspective. Overall, the whole process of data analysis and qualitative research is definitely less structured and less fixed, if you like, than quantitative research and quantitative data analysis. And in fact, some authors call qualitative and quantitative research flexible and fixed designs respectively. And this actually reflects what qualitative research is like. So the design in fact is much more flexible. It's often based on your, not so much on your pre-planned actions, but on what you see right here and right now. So you'll have to make a lot of decisions, spontaneous decisions and interpretations, and from there you'll have to decide what to do next, what to analyze next. So you really have to immerse yourself in this data, and from there you'll need to decide what else needs to be done with the data. And perhaps it is this flexible nature of qualitative research that seems to scare a lot of especially inexperienced researchers off, because this process of qualitative data analysis seems like it's not very structured, it may be confusing and in general very, very difficult. But don't worry, because there are common trends and common patterns that you want to follow when analyzing qualitative data. So all this creativity that I mentioned, this flexibility, is still there, but you still have some kind of structure to it. And to be honest with you, it is this flexibility and it is this depth of analysis that I really like about qualitative research. So when I analyze somebody's data, for example, I treat it as almost as reading a good book. So I literally have a cup of coffee and I just immerse myself in these worlds of personal stories and accounts. And to me, this is very interesting. This is what makes qualitative data analysis so great. So to give you an example, over the last couple of months, for example, I learned so much about completely different topics, like using museums as a site for learning, for example. So education through arts and museums, or intercultural communication, or workplace diversity, and many, many other interesting topics that I previously not known anything about. So I really enjoy it. I really enjoy gaining that new knowledge, and most importantly, these individual perspectives that are central to qualitative data. What I would really like to achieve is to have other people feel the same way as I do about qualitative data analysis. This is why I record these videos and write blog articles, and also at the moment, just to let you know, I'm working on a self-study course about qualitative data analysis. And in that course, I really want to go into much detail of what qualitative data analysis involves. So I'll start from the beginning, like planning your research. So the actual research design, when you need to start thinking about your future analysis, when you, for example, design your interview guides. And then I'll cover other aspects like philosophical beliefs and assumptions, and also a number of procedures that you can apply. So not just coding, but what actually going beyond coding involves. So what after coding? A lot of people seem to think that coding is the final product of data analysis and qualitative research, which is completely not true. So I will cover all these things, and then also how to develop theoretical frameworks, how to develop a theory based on your analysis. And I really hope that this course will help a lot of people understand and enjoy qualitative data analysis.